Hey, it's Maria Okanrende from Dropout UK. We just arrived at Universal Music. We're about to go inside to interview the very beautiful Shontelle. I'm excited. And you guys, come and follow me. Guys, Dropout UK is very, very excited right now. I'm with a very, very beautiful songstress, Shontelle.
Yay!
Why are you laughing when I said beautiful? You're absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, thank you. Well, I already told us the first thing I told you when you walked in.
Yeah, I know, I know. I think you're just being nice.
I'm not. If I tell you that, I mean it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Welcome to London.
Thank you.
How long have you been here this time around?
Well, I've only been in London for one day yesterday. This is my second day.
Yeah.
But I've been in the UK for like the last couple weeks.
Okay.
With Jason did it.
Ooh, how's that been?
That's been great. We did the last day last night at Hammersmith.
Okay.
So that was awesome.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, London is always sick. I even brought up my homie Alexandra Bird.
Oh,
she came out.
Too cool.
She,
oh,
yeah.
Okay.
We go like way back. She's like, we're like sisters. Like,
okay.
That's my homie.
Good to shout her out.
Yeah.
You've actually been on lots of tours. You've toured with Beyonce.
Yeah.
Kids on the Block.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we know lots of really cool things going down on tour. You got any juicy gossip for us?
Juicy gossip? Not really. I mean,
you're lying. I bet you're not allowed to tell us.
Yeah. I'm not telling you.
All right. Okay. So let's take it back. In 2008, you released your first official single, T-shirt.
Yeah.
About, you know, you meeting a guy, that distance between you guys.
Yeah.
Okay, you're really famous now and you're really busy. So
yes.
Can you relate to that? I mean, how difficult is it to maintain a relationship?
Impossible, actually.
Really?
No pun
intended.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's hard. It's, I mean, sometimes you feel like, don't even bother because you just feel like you're hurting another person.
Okay, yeah.
By just not being able to give them what they need.
Yeah.
It's hard.
Okay. That's a nice thing.
I don't want to put anyone in that position
yeah.
where they have to be like missing me all the time
yeah.
or they can't see someone.
Yeah. So what if you're like both in a similar career and you're both really busy? Do you think that helps or that's completely not?
I don't know because I guess all the situations are so different because some people think that works because they're like, well, you know, well, if you take someone that has a similar lifestyle, then you can understand it. But then I look at it and I'm like, if we're both so busy,
then how's it gonna work?
What are we gonna do?
What are you gonna do?
I don't know. I guess maybe I have to wait until I try that. I haven't tried that yet.
Okay, that might be the excellent plan.
Yeah,
that's rough. Okay, so originally from Barbados,
yeah.
doing R&B/pop.
Yep.
So does Rihanna. I'm
yeah.
sure you must get a lot of comparisons to Rihanna.
All
are you fed up
the
with that?
Time. I'm not fed up because I get it. I mean, she's the one who like came and brought out the Barbados flag
okay,
first, you know what I mean? And there's no other reference for people to, like, so then if another artist from Barbados comes out, who else are you going to compare them to, you know what I mean? So,
yeah, okay.
And then the way I look at it, I'm like, well, I probably would care if you were comparing me to, like, a crap artist,
oh, yeah.
but
yeah.
she's so dope.
Yeah, and it's awesome. Yeah.
So, yeah, so, like, I'm like, hey. And plus, you know, it's like every new artist goes through that, whether it's a person from your city or not, like you will be compared to
exactly.
someone who's come before
yeah.
because it's like nobody knows you, so it's kind of like a human nature thing
yeah.
to like, you know, do that and try to like draw a reference or a comparison. But then, you know, eventually there's another artist who comes out that they get compared to you, so you know.
So don't worry, the next one will be compared to you.
Yeah, like Reeves compared to Beyonce all the time
yeah,
when she first
yeah.
came out, and now,
now she's her own.
No one puts them in the same
yeah.
sentence anymore, you know, so.
Rihanna's actually another one of your homies.
Yeah.
How did you guys meet?
Man, just growing up in Barbados, it's so small, like, everybody just...
Yeah, I've got a lot of friends from the Caribbean. They always say that to me. They're like, when they go on holiday, like, St. Lucia, they're like, I saw my friend there.
Right, like, everybody knows each other, and especially, like, once you're in the same generation.
Yeah.
She actually went to the school where my dad went to school, and... But we were both in the cadets together, so that was how, you know, we all knew each other, and, like, we, like, all have the same friends, and we all partied together, and so, you know, that was how that all started. And then it was the funniest thing, because I didn't know she wanted to be a singer or anything.
Oh, really?
She didn't know I wanted to be a singer. I thought she was going to be a supermodel.
Oh, really?
Yes, because she was always, like, people don't realize she's taller than me.
Is she? How tall are you?
I'm, like, 5'9", she's, like, 5'10".
Wow.
Yeah, like, I know, she's very tall. And so, when we were younger, I just thought, wow, she's so stunning, like, she's going to be a supermodel.
You
I knew
do.
She was going to be famous.
Like. Alright, so you're also a songwriter. There's that really lovely hit, 2007, Roll It Girl by Addison Rae.
Yeah.
That song has a lot of attitude, a lot of defiance.
I performed it last night.
Oh, really? Wow.
I love to perform that song in London. Like, they always go crazy. It's so fun.
I wanted to ask, that say something about you, like, have you got a good attitude, or...
Me, me, wine, me, rock, got me, dipso. Hey, look on me, dance to reggae and calypso.
Hey.
Yep.
Yeah, so what, tell us about Shontelle, the personal lady. You know about your music, but what about you?
Me. I'm very free-spirited. I can be very loud. And
you're very friendly too, I have to say.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm definitely... I like to make people feel comfortable. I believe in the golden rule.
Mm-hmm.
You treat others as you would want to be treated, and it's really that simple. So I just try to live my life just based on that all the time. And well, I do have a short temper.
Do you?
I think it's because I'm so nice.
I can't imagine that.
No, I think it's because I'm so nice that I get disappointed a lot because a lot of people aren't nice. So then that frustrates me and could be I could get. Yeah, when I get angry, it's like Jekyll and Hyde. It really is.
Well,
so.
We don't want to believe that.
Your second, it doesn't come out too often, but
I don't think it does. So on your second single, Stuck With Each Other, featuring Okan, that song featured on the Confessions of a Shopaholic.
Yeah.
Have you ever considered acting?
Song? I have. Actually, I really want to get into it more. When I was in school studying law, I was also studying drama and theater arts at the same time. And just before I got signed, I actually got a scholarship to the American Musical and Dramatic Academy, where Jason Derulo went to school.
Oh wow!
Yeah, and
what a small world.
Yeah, so and I actually got a scholarship, but didn't go because then I got signed shortly after.
Okay, wow.
So I sort of choose one or the other.
Yeah.
But hopefully, you know, I can really get back into it.
If you
notice, I try to make, you know, my music videos sort of like little baby films.
Especially the t-shirt, it was great. If you could, or if you do decide to go into acting, what would be the perfect role for you? Like, what could you see Shontelle doing?
I want to be Catwoman. I really want to be.
I think that would be perfect for you.
I want to wear leather cat suits and like crawl up walls and stuff with a whip. I just want to be like, yeah. And then, you know what I thought too? I was like, you know, I could really, I thought if they did like a biopic of Whitney Houston, I was like, I want to play her.
Oh, really?
But then I just heard that Rihanna is
might
doing,
be the bodyguard type
I don't think it's like that she's playing Whitney Houston, because that would be kind of weird for a green-eyed, like, skin person.
Yes.
But there's like a remake bodyguard, and
bodyguard
it's going to be great. Yeah.
So, wow.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's awesome. Yeah. So last year you released Impossible on the new album No Gravity.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful, beautiful song. Tell them I was happy and my heart is broken. All my scars are open. Tell them what I hoped would be impossible. Let's talk about the album though. What does the album say about your music at this point?
Yeah, my new album, No Gravity, I've just been so blessed with it because Impossible is my biggest single to date ever. And that's really taken my career, you know, to a whole another level, which is what you need and what you pray for. But yeah, No Gravity is definitely I mean, the contrast between No Gravity and Shontelligence is basically, Shontelligence sounds like exactly what I was when it came out. Mm-hmm. A girl that just got plucked from Barbados. Okay, it's very warm and islandy, you know, a lot softer almost. And then No Gravity has a lot more edge to it. I experimented a lot with dance and rock and like country.
Cool.
Yeah, like my next U.S. single is called "Say Hello to Goodbye," which you know, which I wrote, and that song actually sounds like a country rock ballad.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
Yeah, you know, it's being a songwriter and just loving music. You know what I mean? It's hard to just do one thing, and luckily, everything I've been doing so far is being embraced well. Maybe I'll come up with a death metal track.
Oh, we can picture that. That'd be cool. That'd be cool. Give it to Dropout UK first.
Yeah.
Okay, so but over here in the UK, Perfect Nightmare is your latest offering.
Yes.
What is a perfect nightmare?
Everyone asks that question. And really, I mean, if you think about it, you probably have a perfect nightmare situation going on in your life. I feel like in every person's life, there's a situation that exists that you know in your heart really shouldn't.
Okay, oh, I see that.
But there's something about it that you enjoy so much that you just can't stop. Like, so, you know, Perfect Nightmare is really about being caught up in a relationship where, I mean, it could just simply be an abusive relationship where you're like, I'm in love so much, but so why am I putting up with all this horrible stuff?
Yeah.
Or it could just be like, you're her boyfriend, but I'm like messing around with you, and I know it's wrong, and I gotta stop it. You know?
Has this come from a true story, Chanta?
I'm not saying anything.
Because I can see it. I can see it in your eyes.
Well, that's what it is.
What's next, Chantal?
Next, I have a lot of exciting things going on. A show and an event in Nigeria coming up.
Ooh, I'm from Nigeria.
Are you serious? Wow. I don't know where in Nigeria yet. I have to find out specifically, but I'm going to Nigeria, and it's gonna be my first time in Africa, so I'm really excited.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I have an event with Tayo Cruz actually at Blackberry soon in Jakarta.
Okay.
So Malaysia. Yeah. That'll be probably my third time there. And then after that, it's just going to be me doing a bunch of promo, you know, releasing all, you know, these new singles and stuff. So I'm going to be busy.
Yeah, I can imagine. But we're excited for you.
Living out of a suitcase.
We're excited for you. And we wish you all the best.
Thank you so
much. And we can't wait to meet you again. Thank you so much.
Thank you.